concept of virtual fence is quite simple. Manage livestock grazing without physical fences. Although it was first developed back in the 1980s, it is only recently that virtual fence has become practical to use on working ranches. Today, virtual fence is developing at a rapid pace, and there are a range of different systems available on the market. This series features early adopters of the technology from around the U.S. and uses their lived experience as a basis to provide viewers with a structured approach to adopting and using virtual fence.
I think of this product as being infant. I've had that conversation with people. Obviously, there's been products on the market now. They're continually improving, so they'll always be changing. But there is a large group of people that have a large interest in the use of these technologies, virtual fencing technologies. And they're creating networks, much like we're doing today, of places you can go, people you can contact, sit down and talk about the use of the technology.
And there is some labor involved right up front. Putting up the towers, designing your system and stuff, you better kind of get educated on how to do that.
And understand not only the potential of the technology, but the limitations thereof.
Making sure you know what the product is capable of and not pushing those boundaries.
How can I utilize this technology in a way and understanding the landscape and cattle behavior so that we're setting up the system to succeed?
You know, with having some consultants help us, you know, with our forage base and all that, you know, and getting a really rock solid grazing plan together. It's made it so much easier.
You need a support network. You need to have a contact. You need to know who you can reach out to or what group you need to reach out to.
There is a force of people here that could help you do it right.
You know, I think for help with grazing management questions, I would definitely recommend talking to County Extension.
Extension is happy to answer questions. We have range management specialist. We have cow-calf specialist. We have beef nutritionist.
Most land-grant institutions in the United States have somebody working on virtual fence technology, or at least aware of somebody working on virtual fence technology. So if you're not in Oregon and you can't reach out to the Eastern Oregon Ag Research Center or the Extension Service here, reach out to the Extension Service in your state. They should be able to help you or put you in contact with somebody that can help answer some of your questions.
And then also, you know, the Natural Resource Conservation Service.
You know, you have an NRCS personnel in every single county, I think.
As far as the technical support for the callers, I think that's still, primarily coming from the companies that you're purchasing the technology from.
The product I'm using, they have some really good tutorials. The actual use of the apps, the actual use of the product, as far as designing pastures, how do you move cattle from pasture to pasture, all that is laid out pretty good. How do you train cattle to collars? There's tutorials on that.
I would be very remiss if I didn't say how important it is that you work with the company that is providing that virtual fence technology. The virtual fence company has actually set up a work group that meets weekly or monthly, depending on the need, to help answer some of those questions.
There are some Facebook groups that have just started. The goal is for people to share what they're learning about. I think those will be really excellent for people to bounce ideas off of each other.
Talk to people about the limitations they run into. I'm always accessible. You can give people my phone number.
There's different types of callers out there. And
some of them you can manage with your cell phone, and you can't manage from your laptop, and some of them you can manage from your laptop, but you can't manage from your cell phone.
Some companies will have a base station that communicates with the caller wirelessly, and then some companies don't have a base station and each caller is connected directly to the cell phone network. So they're kind of set up and idealized for different situations, different kinds of ranches. Basically, if you have complete cell phone coverage over your ranch or not.
For us, one of the biggest limitations and I guess problems we've had is the terrain that we deal with. Heavy timber, big mountains, deep valleys. It's just hard to get coverage to change things once we've already got our original plan set up.
The delay time between when you relay instructions to the callers and when they actually receive them, it's not instantaneous like you would think. There are some limitations on like the space you can confine animals to. And there is gonna be there's a certain point there where an area is too small.
The smaller pasture you have, the more in contact they're gonna come with your buffer zone, your sound zone, and then your shock zone.
And of course, battery life on any collar, whether it's solar or just a lithium powered battery, is gonna depend on how much they're interacting with the boundary more than anything.
Beef cattle that's a tough environment to put electronics. The durability and keeping those devices functional is still a challenge, probably always will be a challenge.
Right now, without the ability for the collar to essentially self-adjust, we're really limited on how much we can do with calves.
We probably contain 95% of the cows. You're never gonna contain them all.
There'll always be cows that will challenge the boundary more than others.
You know, you've got to go out there with a plan, right? You've got to have a plan in mind so that it guides your decision making throughout the season. We build a grazing plan every single year. We've done it since 2017. And it's there to guide our team, you know, when cattle need to be moved, where they need to be moved to, all that kind of stuff.
We're using the rangeland analysis platform to also like map out our forage areas.
What you can do with virtual fencing and being able to better control the grazing gives you many more options.
When you get virtual fence, it's gonna be a really good opportunity it's gonna force you to create a plan because you will have to decide where your pastures are gonna go.
How do we make sure we've got water everywhere we go?
Just know your country, know your water.
Water is the number one limiting resource. It's your most precious resource.
Use your natural topography to your advantage.
Don't set your animal up to fail. Don't put it too close to your water source that you're trying to keep them out of and expect them to walk another mile or something to get that water. You've got to create angles. Don't create square corners. They'll get themselves confused in that square corner.
Make curves, you know, so they can make their way out of it.
Don't let them come down draws partway and try to turn them around. Set that virtual fence up at the top of that draw to keep them out.
Once you get better knowledge of its use, you can get real creative on how you design your pasture.
We set a boundary up on an unburned area, and we were trying to hold them in that unburned area, bordering a burned area. Well, the cattle want to go to that freshly burned grass. It's the new growth, fresh. And so we had them, they could see it, they could smell it, and they could almost taste it. And so they pushed our boundaries just because the temptation was too strong. And so we kind of learned like, you know, those types of things where that temptation is really strong, we need to push those boundaries back and not let them know it's there.
We need to be able to understand the infrastructure on our allotments, water location, the topography, historical use, the fire history, the trail system. Those are just some of the minor things that we have to understand when we look at wanting to incorporate virtual fence technology into our management system. And to be honest, we need to be thinking about those things even without virtual fence technology, because that is what is limiting or affecting our distribution on the landscape.
As you get your grazing plans laid out, you'll kind of use the same idea year to year. And so your time savings as you get deeper and deeper into the project are absolutely going to be evident.
You don't know what you're getting yourself into.
We're always a phone call away. We've got resources on our website.
We're going to be providing some fact sheets to help people kind of navigate through this.
You don't have to be the first person. It's better to get it from somebody that's already done it.
I mean, my generation is all about technology. I mean, we grew up with it. We know it.
You're going to have mess ups and you're going to learn as you go. And that's just part of it.
The important part is you've got to understand what you want to do with it before you get it.
And understand not only the potential of the technology, but the limitations thereof.
Be thoughtful in what you're doing. plan ahead.
And I can see on that screen, you know, right where those cows are.
I can sleep good at night knowing that cattle are going to be where they're supposed to be.
I think I'm out.
All right.
I think you reached the end.